What might aliens look like? Nothing like us, possibly. Hey guys, Amy here with DNews. We haven't found extraterrestrial life just yet, but that might be because we're looking for entirely the wrong thing. Let's start with a recap of what we know on Earth. Carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, and sulfur are the six basic building blocks of all life forms on Earth, at least that we know of. Phosphorus is an integral part of DNA and RNA, the structures that carry all genetic instructions for life. Carbon, meanwhile, is the main component of sugars, proteins, fats, DNA, muscle tissue, pretty much everything that makes up your body. Life on Earth also requires something called phospholipid bilayer membrane, a strong, permeable, water-based membrane that houses the organic material inside every cell, vesicles made of which are called liposomes. So these are the things astronomers will eventually look for on other planets and in alien environments to find life. And because all life on Earth needs water, we tend to look for water in the search for extraterrestrial life. And really, because the only planet we know life exists on is the Earth, we take what we know about the Earth and extrapolate to apply it to other planets. But there's increasingly more research to suggest that life on other worlds won't necessarily have the same makeup as it does here. In 2010, a team of researchers released a study saying they discovered the first known microorganism able to thrive and reproduce using arsenic, a toxic chemical. In a laboratory setting, researchers successfully grew a strain of gamma proteobacteria microorganisms on a diet lean on phosphorus but heavy on arsenic, before removing the phosphorus entirely. The microbes didn't die. Instead, they thrived, with later generations substituting arsenic for phosphorus in its DNA and other cellular components. The arsenic became a building block for a new strain of cell. When this news came out, it was massively exciting for the astrobiology and space world, but the discovery was eventually debunked. The phosphorus-free medium in which the microbes thrived with arsenic in their DNA turned out to have just enough phosphorus in it to support life as we know it. But it didn't turn out to be the nail in the coffin of finding interesting alien life. Just last month, scientists at Cornell University modeled a cell that could exist on Saturn's moon Titan. Titan, Saturn's largest moon, has a thick atmosphere, liquid ethane and methane seas, an organic-rich chemistry somewhat reminiscent of a frozen early Earth. Titan couldn't support organic cells as they exist on Earth, but it could support methane-based, oxygen-free cells. The researchers theorized a cell membrane called an azotosome. It's a membrane analogous to the liposomes we know exist in earthly life. It has the same stability and flexibility. But these azotosomes are made from nitrogen, carbon, and hydrogen molecules, molecules we know exist in Titan's seas. So it's possible that carbon-free life could exist on Titan, or else on some exoplanet or exomoon with a similar structure. So, to be fair, the arsenic-based bacteria was eventually disproved, and the possible cell that could exist on Titan is only a model. But still, the definition of life keeps expanding, and that makes the ongoing search for extraterrestrial life that much more interesting. And switching gears just a little, we are really happy that our new channel, Seeker, launched this week. Here on DNews, we take a look at the news from a science angle, and they take a look at the news from the human side, like this video here about the fight to save New York subway dancers.
New advocacy group for the dancers called Waffle argue that the artistic camaraderie of these tight-knit groups actually keeps a lot of young people away from neighborhood crime and gang culture.
So make sure you check that video out, it's the first link in the description, and subscribe to Seeker so you never miss a video. So what do you guys think about non-carbon-based life forms? Cool science fact or unlikely science fiction? Let us know in the comments below, or you can let me know directly on Twitter as AST Vintage Space. And don't forget to subscribe for more DNews every day of the week.